Good afternoon. Before I talk about this week's issues in Washington, I want to express my appreciation to all the law enforcement and all the first responders who are dealing with yesterday's shooting in Collierville. Our hearts go out to all the victims, to their families, and everyone in Collierville. Yesterday, my staff and I were in contact with Collierville town officials and with law enforcement. And I gotta tell you, I greatly appreciate the leadership of Collierville Police Chief Dale Lane, his entire staff, and all the other law enforcement agencies who have been and continue to assist in this matter. I promise to provide whatever federal resources that they need. Now in Washington yesterday, my colleagues and I voted to fund our troops and strengthen our national security. This year's National Defense Authorization Act, which is also known as the NDAA, passed Congress yesterday, Thursday, largely on a bipartisan basis, 316 in favor, 113 against. The NDAA boosts top-line defense spending by nearly $25 billion, and it's needed. It also authorizes a 2.7% pay increase for our brave service members, their families, and includes numerous other provisions to hold the Biden administration accountable for its reckless and ill-planned withdrawal from Afghanistan. And lastly, it focuses on countering the Chinese Communist Party and establishing supply chain independence and security. Now, the bill's not perfect, but it's a step in the right direction, and it protects our country, our servicemen, and our servicewomen. Now, not everything in Washington these days is bipartisan. You know that. Today, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats brought up a bill that legalizes abortions up until birth. It's a radical bill, and it eliminates nearly all the pro-life protections on a state and federal level, as well as essentially making abortion on demand legal. I voted against the bill, which passed largely on a partisan basis. I've got to tell you, I'm always going to work to defend the sanctity of life and the rights of the unborn. Now, as always, if you have any questions or concerns or comments, please don't hesitate to reach out to our offices in West Tennessee or in Washington. You can visit my website, it's custoff.house.gov, for updates on legislative activity, for statements that I've made in the press, and also for constituent services. It's an honor to represent all of you all in West Tennessee, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you very much.